Alright, there's some important things to say before the video begins. So you know how my voice was crackling a little in the last video? Well, unfortunately, it happened again, which was complete bullcrap. I literally did 3 test recordings before this, and my voice was fine.
3 freaking test recordings.
So when I saw that the real recording came out like that, I felt like throwing my mouse against the wall, but I really wanted to upload this video anyway, so please bear with me. I'll be bracing for dislikes. The cringe starts in 3, 2, 1.
Hey guys, how's it going? This is InstaFizz, and today I am recording some HiveSwap again. Now, let's continue where we left off last time. The last video wasn't as long as I wanted it to be. So let's just continue. We were stuck with Joey, trapped inside this planet that I forgot where the trolls live, and we're trying to get back in here to find our way home. We're also still not sure why there's monsters attacking our house. You can hear awful slams and crawls coming from the other side of this door. You aren't even gonna try opening it. Byrus is plainly freaked out by the sounds coming from the other side of this door. You can't blame him, because you are too. Oh, this does indeed seem to be a diagram of this portal, for all the good that does you, which is currently none at all. Isn't that what I was supposed to do? Isn't that what I was supposed to do? A busted up robot? It seems like something pretty intense went down here just before you arrived. Keep Byrus away from that thing. It could still be dangerous. Let's see. A futuristic looking door in a gloomy futuristic looking bunker like place. Maybe all the answers are through here? I love combining Byrus with everything. You have no idea how to open this thing. You don't even see a handle. If you had to guess, it looks like it's automatic, but the power seems to be off in here. You think it's kind of hard to tell. I wanted Byrus to interact with this. Oh, I see. No matter what, it's gonna tell me that. What if I combine the paper? Okay, what did they want me to do? So what do I do with it? Okay, I'm just gonna be quickly browsing through this to see what do I do with the paper. What's going on, please? Just answer the question. This paper seems kind of schematic from the portal I just came through. It looks kind of familiar, not just the portal, but the paper itself. I don't know how that'd be possible. Is this a diagram for the snake machine? I remember that thing is a guide to the weapon. Weapon, you mean the snake portal? Oh, the code. Okay, yes, the portal. Can I unlock the snake machine with this? What should I do? Unlock the snake machine? Oh, the serpent security program for your hive's power is Hexagrid. Let me see. Just put all X fingers on the back of your tablet until the control panel up. Oh, X10. Okay. I get it. We have to combine this and this? No? What the hell do we do? Put all X fingers? What? I don't get it. Okay, I'll be right back. Oh, is it right here? You place all 10 of your fingers on the back of the tablet and approach the control panel. Some kind of password entry program appears on the screen. What the heck? Oh, it's a game of snake. Oh, I have to use the arrow keys. It's JavaScript snake. What? Oh, that's bullcrap. So this is like a JavaScript snake then. It's a JavaScript snake. Also, this music is awesome. Okay. JavaScript snake for the win! Okay. Yeah, boy! Yeah! Oh. Oh. Oh, oh, oh. Look at her face. Oh no! Oh no. Look at her face, man. I'm sorry that it had to be so zoomed out. There was even the resolution couldn't change that. No way, if you wanted to be killed by a weird monster in the basement, you would have stayed at home. Fire seems to sense the ferocious deer cat monster lurking just on the other side of this door. I love combining buyers with everything. I love it, love it, love it. There's a lot of boxes, crates, miscellaneous containers, etc. Pretty mundane stuff. Mundane stuff. IYHO, not your first box stack rodeo. Does this stack of bullet-filled boxes run by- wait, bullet-filled? Does Byers miss his home? Is Byers freaked from being shot across space? I mean, if I were a bird, I'd be freaked out by lots of things. This seems to be a map, but you don't recognize the shapes of any landmasses depicted on it. Or well, actually, now that you think about it, they maybe do look kind of familiar, but you're not sure where you've seen them before. You don't really know what this is all about. You would kind of like to never find out now, please. Hey. Hey, Exeros, are you there? I don't know how I feel about a code name Exeros. It's pretty close to Exeros, don't you think? I imagine I called you, damn it. Not that I would ever do that. Sorry. Okay, I really know what to say to any of that. Sorry, it's fine, stop apologizing. It's actually really annoying when you do that all the time if I. Oh, sorry. Look, forget about it. I want to ask you about the security console. I played the game on it, but all that happened was a forklift drove straight into the force field and exploded. Your forklift exploded? It's not mine, though. Is it yours? Sorry, I wrecked it. No, of course not. Or, I mean, do you want me to take it because it's broken? I want to mind. I mean, whatever. Up to you. Alright, a weird monster menaced me into the other room. And there's only one door. Is this kind of a bad situation? Weird monster. Yeah, that deer cat thing. Deer cat thing? Are you having a fight with your Lucis? Not that it's any of my business. Okay, I know what a Lucis is because I have read all of Homestuck. So, I'm just gonna say, it not mine! Okay. A Lucis is basically the parent of a troll. Simply put, but the difference between humans and parents. Okay, the difference between human parents and children and troll parents and children is that they're not obliged to love each other. Sometimes the Lucises would even like eat the trolls. Sometimes. Nothing here is mine. Not the forklift or the tablet or monster tablet was about to lunge at me before I ran into here. Wait a minute. Are you actually not textured to damage? No, I'm Joey. Joey Claire. I don't know what's going on. There's a bunch of big computers and boxes. I don't know where I am or who you are, but you keep acting like you knew what was going on. What are you doing with the Tetris's tablet? Do you mean Trapper Keeper laptop? I found it on the floor. Oh no. Is Tetris Damick there? Maybe I could talk to him instead. Please. Please give me the tablet to Tetris Damick, please. I don't know who Tetris Damick is. I don't know who you are. Could you look for him, please? Okay, yeah, I'll root around in this room that's filled with guns! Okay, thanks. I love this game. I love this game. Some sort of highly advanced. Okay, yeah. I love this game. I love this game. That was hilarious. Let's see. This reminds me of Jude's dorky conspiracy theories. Although I guess maybe those weren't actually conspiracy theories, more like conspiracy facts apparently. You guess the same would go for all the stuff, but geez, do these dorks always have to dig themselves into such crazy bone holes? What's with the layer of scrolls and everything? Who's that? Who's there right here? They look awesome. Like Briska or something. My favorite character in Holstuck. Okay, yeah. Same stuff. What? Did you find him? No! Oh no. I don't know what to do. What should I do? Oh my god! Why on earth are you asking me? What's Earth? What? Oh. My. God. Jude, is that you? Is this another one of your stupid practical jokes? This isn't funny. No, I'm Exafros. Oh, okay, Exafros, tell me what is going on! I don't really know. I'm kind of upset because you're yelling, and that makes it harder to think. I know I'm not very smart or good at anything, but I really am trying my best. I'm sorry. I can't believe this. I'm the one who just got shot through space into an alien nightmare whorehouse, and you expect me to make you feel better? Look, we all have self-esteem issues, but there's time and place for pathetic groveling, and it's not when I'm trying to not be devoured by alien monsters. Wait, you're an alien? I'm 2 seconds away from throwing this disgusting joke I've seen in any of the several of the massive piles of armed and dangerous garbage around me. Wait, no, don't! This is so exciting, I've never met an alien before. I'm like seriously loving it. Most trolls never meet aliens until they go off the planet to conquer them. But okay, well, like, you could be messing with me. Are you messing with me? The Tetrarch says I have to stop being so trusting. Oh, I know. Say only something an alien would say. I'm a nightmare squid god. I'm going to tap dance your sad little nerd body. Oh my god, no. I wish she wasn't so harsh. I seriously wish she wasn't so harsh. I kept feeling bad for Jude. And poor Exafros. I'm gonna tap dance your silly little bot. No, I'm from a planet named Earth. That sounds pretty alien. Well, if nothing else, Jude is gonna be very jealous. Sorry. This is all a little nuts, and the deer cat maybe got me a little rattled. So you're not an alien. I mean, if this seriously isn't Earth, which between the snake machines and the deer cat and the sci-fi technology, I'm willing to believe. Plus, there were some other monsters earlier, so I am having that kind of day. Monsters? Yeah, I managed to get past them barely. Whoa, you're so cool. You're like on a real adventure. Wait, what color is your blood? What kind of a question is that? I didn't mean to be disrespectful. I just want to make sure I knew before I made a mess of things. Okay, it's red? Really? Me too! Awesome, we can even be friends. This is so cool. Maybe I can even help you. Okay, so I gotta explain, yeah. Trolls have different colored blood. Simply put. Like, yeah, that's literally it. Trolls have different colored blood. If you haven't read Homestuck already, do it. How? The Tetrash is loose. This knows me. Look, calm down if I can get over there. By Lucis, do you mean the deer cat monster? Yes. That's wonderful, thank you. Yeah, except, I don't know, I'm still worried this might all be a big test. A test I don't follow, sorry. Boy, it's getting kind of frustrating having to say that over and over. The Tetrarch is always testing me. If this is the final exam of secrecy and I blow it, he's gonna be really disappointed. Oh, I know. If you can prove you're an alien, I'll come over and help you. Do you want me to say more alien things? I mean, I have no way to verify if those are true or not. Okay, send me a picture of you. I don't have any photos of me, and anyway, how could I get it to you? I'm trapped in here by the monster. Aren't you using Tetris attacks to take the pics with that and X-Men it over? Pics? X-Men? Pictures. Transmit. Okay, that's kind of a weird ass except Rose. Look at this shot, here goes. Hey, we're playing as Exafros now. Also, that wasn't. Wait! Oh, wait! Wait! 1 sec. Wait! Rewind! Rewind back. Okay, I'm gonna rewind the clip. I saw that the thing with like the weird symbol. It was the symbol of the the giant evil fish girl thing in Homestuck. Oh my god, that is not good. Your name is Exafros. You're having a difficult evening, just one of many in a particularly difficult life, because you are rust blood trash. You just witnessed beams of red and green energy erupt from the hive of your best friend's tetraedemic, right before Squadron of Imperial Drones snatched up half of your neighbors, so it's safe to say your revolutionary efforts are not going great. Oh, and it seems you received a package. What is this? Oh, it must be my fighting method besides tap dancing. The door to your respite block, where you sleep. You're standing on your gant or something. Whatever, another word for balcony. It's a delivery from your Scythian with the item you ordered quite a long time ago. You guess it arrived during all the confusion. What else is there? Outglut. A suburb of the great stem cluster of Thrash Thruster. Outglut is where you grew up. Tetraedemic's hive is here. You hope he's in one of the parts that hasn't been annihilated by massive beams of light. Let's see what this is. You open the package. Inside is the FLARP manual. This edition of FLARP is focused on spy games, intrigue, and rebellion. Tetraedemic modeled a lot of his underground residence ideas after this system. Now let's combine it with other things. You know the drill. That's a really cool FLARP module about a city ruled by monsters who view the population as a source for food and cheap labor. Or there used to be a FLARP about that, but all the copies were burned down and everyone who worked on it was culled as rebels. Ah, yeah, I think this connects with the Homestuck storyline in some way. Playing FLARP with Tetric was Tetraedemic's idea. Most things are. Okay, let's enter our house. More awesome music! You play Pusher, of course. Burgrundis are ideally suited to this position because of their telekinetic powers and their ability to commune with dead players. Also, Pusher is the most dangerous position. No one really cares if Rustblood gets killed. Read. You've already tidied your butler training materials. Even the ones you used to tidy. I don't know anymore. I don't even know anymore. This must be their sleeping bag. This is a roughly around where you might normally be going to sleep, but the current circumstances, i.e., your imminent death if you don't escape, are not conducive to sleep. They are conducive to dying, though. Hey, computers, am I right? It's your tablet. Use it for pretty much everything. Your auto-tune mic is plugged into it. Ah, heck yeah, YouTuber stuff. It says something different. Use it for pretty much all your computing needs. Perfect device for a kid on the go. Except you spend most of your time at home, so it usually just stays right here in your room. Unfortunately, a kid on the go is probably exactly what you are now. You should really grab it. Besides, your mic is plugged into it, and you're sure you're not leaving that behind. But you gather both tablet and mic with one practice motion. They're attached, so the motion probably didn't require as much practice as you might think. You then proceed to have this conversation again. From the other side, it's all new to Exafros, but it might be a little dull to read the whole thing over again. Let's just pick up where we left off. Oh my god, what did it say? It's like, okay, you proceed to have the conversation you had before, but we already read it, so let's just pick up where we left off with Joey. Do you want me to say more alien things? I mean, okay, so this is when they send a picture. Okay. I can't look. I'm so sorry, Joey. That was so cringy. Or are you having a strange collection of cross-legged physical and mental diseases? Either way, you need my help. I'm so sorry, Joey. Ugh. I couldn't even look, man. He's probably hungry. Hussy, you're cruel. Well, Pumpkin, you're cruel. Anyways, man, if you're an alien, we gotta get you out of here. The Heroes hates aliens. Aha! I think that's her name. That's her name. I think. The giant fish lady from Homestuck. I think her name was the Harris. The what? Harris. Oh, well, she's awful. Yeah, definitely. That's the symbol I saw earlier. That's the creature thingy. I doubt she's ever met one. But to hear her talk, she hates aliens as much as she hates lowbloods. Which I guess you also are. You're practically a member of the Resistance already. I'm not sure whether I'd really be confused or really concerned about you. Do you need help? One time, when things got really bad with my brother, my babysitter took him to the doctor, and it seemed to help. Okay, wait, what? One time, when things got really bad with my brother, my babysitter took him to the doctor, and it seemed to help. What's a brother? What's a babysitter? What's a doctor? I know what a doctor is, I know what a babysitter is, and I know what a brother is. I'll think for a sec. I'm just gonna ask about a doctor, please. Wow, and I thought my home life was neglectful. Okay, I'm definitely concerned. Being concerned is what friends do for each other. I've never had anyone but Tetra Academic concerned about me before. XXD! Oh, jeez. I bet the other Tetrarchs will be extremely excited to hear there's an alien helping us now. Sure. I'm sort of pretty focused on not being killed by the monster in the other room at the moment. That's kind of my main deal right now. I don't really have a lot of time for anything else. Right, yeah, of course. XXD! I'll help you. And because Tetrarch 2, because, well, I hope this is also helping you somehow. Which reminds me, we really shouldn't be talking like this. Like what? Tetrarch Demi says we always have to assume our communications are being monitored. That's exactly the kind of conversation I shouldn't be having. I better hurry up and get over there. On my way now, please don't message me anymore. It's dangerous. BRB. In person, I mean. Okay, let's head over there. Let's head over there. Oh my god, this is an awesome house. Wait. This is all awesome. Let's see here. Some sort of band. Another thing. Another thing. Another thing. What's that? What's that mouth zipper thing right there? And the Lucis, I think. This soundtrack is amazing. The squeaky floor sound effect thing. Let's look around more. Aww. Ain't that adorable? They're Lucis and everything. What about here? That is awesome. That is so cute. This is from the 12th Heracles Eve when Tamek gave you the auto to. Oh. This was his way of letting you know he started a band and that you were the singer, and also that your voice could use a little help. That face. Let's see what's inside this room. It's a game room! Yo! Paul's right at the height of exciting sport. You're pretty busy right now. Only chumps play video games when they have obligations they should be tending to. Who what are you talking about? You can't open the sports belts with your hand. Try thinking before you act. Okay, let's just get out of there. What about this? Your smear spinner has gotten a lot of useful lately. Wow, you could just even look at that even glisten of mucus on the. Oh, beautiful. You can almost take pride in it. Let's go downstairs! You think you should find something to protect yourself with before descending into the violent unknown of your own hive. Preferably a weapon you know well. What are you talking about? Why are you living here, darn it? It's just your faithful old score drain, which you haven't bothered draining recently. Inside of it, rusty fluid and floor filth gray sludge. So I guess we grab a weapon. Let's clean. Okay, never mind. We need to find a weapon. And what could that be? We're going to try to find a weapon. This soundtrack, man. Let's look in this drawer. Oh, hey, it's your arena stick bug gear. You play pusher. It brings back fond memories of your seasons playing in the Alkalic Grub League. You're trying out for the Thresh Thrust Junior League, so you want to put your little rusty. If you blow it, you can get cold. Between band practice with Tetrarch Damic, Revolution lectures from Tetrarch Damic, and bolting practice, you mostly serve Tetrarch Damic, and you really have not the time you need to play. Speaking of, there's your brand new butler uniform. It brings back less than fond memories of when you ordered it. Sweeps ago, delivery to Rustwood, like you is so slow. And hey, there's your smash suit from when Tetrarch. Okay, from where Tetrarch helped that practice call action move suit. Your memory from that time is a little hazy, actually. Okay, that was pointless. We need to find a weapon. What's this? What is that saying? Looking at the dozer always helps you get to sleep, and it's looking at the snow globe what always makes you nervous. No, it's not a real one, but still. Okay, so we gotta find a weapon, right? Oh wait, we can switch back to Joey? Was that necessary? Wait, hang on. Okay, fine, let's just go switch back to Exit Bros. We need to find a weapon. No? Oh, that's a cool mouse, by the way. Oh, wait, should we just read this? Oh, no. Okay, let's go back downstairs and see what it says. You think you should find something to protect yourself with before sending into the violent unknown of your own hype, preferably a weapon you know well. Further conversation will put you and Joey Alien at even greater risk. Well, you shouldn't even be thinking about stuff with the physics the Harris has at her command. It's probably better to maintain radio silence for now. So, what do I do? Do I look in the game room and see if I can find a weapon? Your Exultan Matzos Babylon figurine is the jewel of your collection. You've taken some pretty good thumps to the nug bone in your day. The pusher is the only player allowed to score, so there's prime targets for opposing defense. The helmet's so worn out that it's basically worthless, except for its sentimental value, which is still pretty low. Oh wait, I think I see a weapon. Right here, perhaps? You try to pull the cube at free, but it seems you wedged in this a little too tight. Whoops. We need to find something that we pry loose. Okay, I know, the cleaning supplies. That's what we need. It's just your faithful Ord Scourge, right? Which you haven't been bothered in draining recently. Inside of it, rest of fluid and fluorophyll and colas to make a repugnant gray sludge. Cleaning supplies, the noble instrument of your future career, I guess. It kind of depresses you to keep them anywhere. You like to have fun, so you just dump them at the end of the hallway. Maybe if your hallway's really clean, the drones will stop trying to burn your neighborhood down and kill you. Ah, there's the rust blood, Moxie. Oh wait, I think I know what I have to do. Do I have to do that? Yeah, you can't quite lift a cube with your telekinesis. The best pushers can, but you're not one of them. So what do I use to get this thing free? There's nothing over here. It's your sports vault. It's just a huge heavy vault themed with sports, arena, stickball specifically, and obviously. It's the only place in the hive you can store food for your Lucis. He's so strong, he can easily break into any other hiding place. It has a special telekinesis space interface. It has to wear you out a little, and the combination's pretty hard to remember. So... what am I doing? Oh, I'm not playing? Is that John Egbert? That looks like John Egbert. Did I? That's a rough one. It can't be hard to remember the path where you're already concentrating on your shaky telekinesis. It helps you have some kind of guide on here. You got the thing, but you don't think it's in this room. Picking the lock is way above your challenge rating. You should probably put your mind to figure out another way to open it. It's absolutely permitted for you to use your real-life telekinesis in a FLARP session. Of course, yours is so pitifully weak, it's not like it was going to be an unfair advantage any way you sliced it. So what was I supposed to do? Hold on a sec. I want to see this cutscene again. Okay, let's actually read it this time. It can be hard to remember the path when you're already concentrating your shaky telekinesis. It helps if you have some kind of guide in your hand. You got just the thing, but you don't think it's in this room. Would it be perhaps this guide right here? Your drops are rebellious. That was awesome. You drop some rebellious anti-establishment rants about Volts and your Lucis, and some other half-formed concepts about the case system. It's pretty solid, but the Volt is having none of it. So we have a guide written somewhere, and apparently it's not this one. So we're gonna find it. Is it on this stack of bookshelves? What do we do? Aha! Wait, study. You pretty much got this memorized already. It's like a fork, make a fork, knife fork, fool's fork. That about covers it. What is it even? What is it? Your Wayne Grid Study Scroll. Your aware grid study scroll. To be honest, only indigos really care about what forks go there, and they crush anything they pick up anyway. Bend. You don't use your hands to bend spoons, you use the power of imagination. By which you mean weak, unreliable physics powers. You use these to practice your bending powers of telekinesis. You still aren't very good yet, but you sure showed these spoons who's boss. Yes, that's right. Practice makes almost etiquette. That's the Burgrundy way. Your mind flexes with the pulsing might of your phenomenal telekinetic powers. You bend a tiny little silver spoon without even using your little grubby fingers. Big tough guy. Better bring this along just in case you run into any bent soup. Bent soup. Bent soup. Bent soup. Oh my god. Does that mean we go and will the spoon help me with anything? Like this? You wedge the bent spoon in between the hilt and the wall and... Ah! You got the cubet! This thing packs a wallop, especially when the tip is chalked and is carried behind you. Your cubet is way too big for the precise telekinetic and actual sports maneuvers necessary to solve the sports vault locking mechanism. How do we open this thing then? How do we open this thing? How do we open this thing? I'm gonna watch this one more time. Some kind of guide. Oh, what if it's downstairs? Okay. Let's see. What? I don't see what's wrong with this. Okay, news troll. Doesn't look. Oh. This person again. Huh. Wonder what's up with that. Oh hey, it's the Lucis. Exit? The Lucis is obeying his bestial parental instincts to protect you from danger by blocking the door. Eh? Good dead. Best sloth. Aha! Another Homestuck reference. Good dog, best friend. That's what it's a reference to. Either that or he just fell asleep there. So we're gonna have to find a way to move this fellow. Aw, oh, dang it, you're Lucis sleeping somewhere totally inconvenient again. Come on, wake up, zoo smell? What? This suddenly came up. I don't know why. Move. You ask Zeusmel to move. At first, you're friendly and casual, as if you expect him to move easily. Then you try being polite, but you're a little distant. Your tone becomes annoyed, then firm, followed by stern, finally shifting to angered. Oh, did I have to enter a name for them? Nothing works. You can't just reach him. The only thing Zeusmel needs to care about is his sloth treats. Telekinesis. Who are you kidding? You can barely lift a spoon without passing out. If he's gonna be moved, it's gonna have to be him doing the moving. Gonna make him what you want, you guess. Like these, perhaps? What's this? Sometimes when you're feeling especially rebellious, you wish all the good toppings were reserved for high bloods. Leftover from Tetrarch Danik's early Wriggling Day party. He doesn't turn 7 sweeps old for a couple wipes, but you want to celebrate him before his rites of maturation. I thought trolls didn't celebrate birth. That's what I remember. Hang on. Always useful in case you need to whip out a souffle. You're so bad at that, but it's an inventory part of your future job, so... Are they still in here? Biosol really doesn't keep them well. What about eggs? Eating an unarranged Cluckbeast ova is a great way to fill your acid tubes with horrifying parasites. Who probably wouldn't get along with your benevolent parasites or your benign parasite? That's disgusting. Git. Pick up the grub juice hydration cylinders. Nice, now if you need a quick restorative for your psychic stamina, you'll just have that in your hand instead of not having it like some kind of chump. Now, let's see if we can get them to move. He's very particular about his diet. He only eats sloth treats, and he only eats lots of them. Where do I get that? That wasn't in the fridge. I can't click on anything right here, can I? Okay, yeah, I already clicked on that. What's this? All the best chefs cook on very high treat. You are not one of the best chefs, which is just as well since your crisp range kinda sucks. Besides, how you know what to cook if Damek doesn't tell you what he wants? So does Tetrarch just kinda push Damek around? Also, this fur everywhere is not the best. So we're going to find sloth treats, and they're not in this room. Okay, let's see. Oh, I can change the channel. Yeah! Yeah! That's her! That's her! That's her! That's her right there. That's the... Here, hold on. Right there. And change it to static. And this... Let's just put it on there. What's all this? As a rust blood, you're not permitted to have luxurious circular discs. Only the standard hexagons. Well, that's a shame. The couch. These lounge planks aren't full of so poor slime or anything like that. They're just comfortable horizontal surfaces suited to either the sitting or lying palm positions. We're gonna need some treats. Yeah, I don't know where to find them. You subscribe to a wide variety of hip periodicals. Arena, Stickball Illustrated, Grubs, Dear Annaly. Those are actually the only titles you know. The rest always incorporate the magazine's names on the cover into some sick graphic design to the point that you can't actually tell what the name is. This one with the graffiti or a muscle beast throwing up is usually about movies though. Okay, we're still gonna need to find those sloth treats. Up here. Your spice rack is where you keep your spices. Who would have known? The time. Look at that, it's nearly escape for your impending death o'clock. You better not be late. What's this? Pick up the Rusher playbook, and now if a situation- AHA! 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 We have to go back to the game room! We have to go back to the game room! We have to go back to the game room! Back to the game room! They said earlier that's where they keep all their treats. Right here. Haha! Oh my. Now you can get the sloth treats. What a trial that was. Luckily, he has such a slow metabolism. Grab the sloth treats! You know just what to do with these! Ha ha ha! Let's go back and do this thing. Back. Right here. Oh wait, no. Sloth treats. You just got the thing to get it moving. Here are you, zoo smell. Oh, he seems a bit sluggish. Oh, he is a sloth. He looked like a dog. Exit. A package. Whatever could it be? Wait. Okay, I can go forward. Can I just ignore it though? It's kind of a drag living across the street from billboards advertising that Harris is garbage. Well, that's what's on the way across the street from your best friend. Oh wait, what? Your neighbor's hive is a pretty choice. You have to admit, you like your hive, but sometimes you wish you'd been a little order that freshly pupated where the carpenter joys demand you design it. If you had it to do over again, you obviously had included more rumpus rooms. Now what the heck is this thing? Oh. Scratch error received. All future messages to and from this device are protected from third parties for surveillance. As a special one-time offer, all past messages are protected as well. Do you agree that you already suggested to the terms of service? Yes. I don't like the sound of the word scratchware. That wasn't a good word in the. Oh my God! Oh no! So much thumbnail material. Hello? Hey Joey, it's Joey, right? Yes, that's right, and you're Exeros. Actually, no, I'm Exifros. Oh, oops. Are you okay? What's going on? I thought we weren't supposed to talk. Something weird happened, I thought. I think it's safe now. What do you mean? Real quick. Do you have a green and white symbol on your chat window now? Oh, hey, yeah, that wasn't there before. So it protects us. Now we don't need a code. Okay, I think we're safe then to chat anyway. Okay, good. I still don't get what the danger is, but I guess I'm gonna need to trust you if I have any hope of getting out of here. Well, some bad news on that front. A missile hit my hive and I'm buried under the debris in my lawn ring. Lawn ring? Buried? A missile? Buried? Are you okay? Yeah, I think so. I can't really move, but my body hurts a lot, and I'm kind of worried about one of these drones, and it's going to swoop down and finish me off. That's not okay at all. You need way more help than I do right now. I don't want to be a bother, but I was about to say something to those effects. Or, I mean, I was gonna say I'm sorry I can't help you anymore, and we're both stuck waiting to find out if the flames or the drones will reach us first. Nuts to that, I'm gonna save you. Aren't you stuck? I was, but that missile knocked some boxes over. I don't think I could have moved on my own, so in a weird way, it kind of helped. Boxes? They were blocking up a vent shaft. I'm gonna climb up there and see where it leads. Wow, you're kind of like a real-life action hero. Wow. Oh shucks, I want to help you the way you were gonna help me, and you're putting yourself a lot more at risk than I realized. I repeat. I've been meaning to ask, what the heck does that mean? You can use letters and numbers to make a little face. Tetrarch Dynamic told me he likes it when I smile. We have those where I'm from, but I don't know what the X means. Oh, those are my horns. Your horns? Yeah? Like the guy on this screensaver? I think so. That's probably not me though. But those are real? Do you not have horns? I thought they were out of frame. No, I don't have horns, jeez. What a question. That's so weird. And cool. You really are an alien. I never thought I'd meet one. Well, today's your lucky day. I mean, it really seems to not be that, but you understand what I'm going for here. I think so, yeah. I'll be there as quick as I can, so apply pressure to the wounds and try not to move too much. It's okay. The weight of the rubble crushing my body is pressing down on my wounds and preventing me from not moving at all. Man. Exerox. Buddy. You really gotta work on your concept of what's okay. Well, that's nice. No. Oh my god. Okay, yeah, we have to go through the vent shaft. Aha, I think this is what I saw in one of the other trailers. Look at her face. Yeah, this is what I saw in a trailer. They were almost done with the game by this point. Ah, poor Joey. That must be Tetrarch's room. Hey, I made it through the vent shaft. Wow. That's pretty exceptional. Yes, gosh, thank you. It was a little creepy and in retrospect fairly dangerous. Or shall I say it was more dangerous than I expected? Well, I would rather you didn't, honestly. Oh, I'm sorry. No, it's okay, but typing quirks are sort of... I notice you don't really have one, but they're kind of a thing that's exclusive to you, no? I mean, it's okay if you're using Keisha, but there's someone you're close to. No offense, I don't know that well yet. I don't know you that well yet. Oh, I see. Well, I'm sorry. I will know better from now on. No, I'm probably being weird about it. I'm sorry. You're annoying, annoying. I suppose it's okay to tell people when they do something that bothers you. Better to express how you feel than sit on a fur while the other person has no idea. What kind of a foundation for friendship would that be? Oh. Yo, you're right. By the way, how much rubble are you covered in exactly? I'm not really sure how I'm gonna get you out of there. Oh, that wouldn't be too hard if you could find my hover pad. It's around there somewhere. I use it to move my Lucis around, but Tetrarch Damic borrowed it. To move some guns, I think, or maybe his drums. Oh, bad timing, haha. Well, I mean, that was a couple sweeps ago, so I guess it's pretty much his now. You know what they say, your hive is my hive, hehehehe. Actually, that's mostly what Tetrarch says as he's taking my stuff. Oh, that's nice, but where's this hover pad exactly? Yeah, it sounds like Tetrarch is just abusing him. Sorry. It's fine, I don't want you to bleed to death or whatever while typing. I think it's probably still in Tetrarch's loft above the respite block. Do you know where you are now? Not really, but there's a ton of guns. It's filthy in here. It's kind of dark and creepy. I don't want to make you anxious, but that describes every block in the Tetrarch's hive. Great. I'll message you when I make some more progress, I suppose. Okay. Yeah. I think I'm about to pass out from a blood loss, so I'm gonna chill out for a little while. Hang there, I'll find that hover pad soon. Let's see what this thing is. You pick up the... Let's see. Looks like this is the Big Book of Beasts. You flip through, glimpsing tons of monsters at various levels of white, weed, wit, black, cute, sprain, spectacular. You can use this to learn more about the weird alien life on this weird alien planet. Neat. I'm gonna save... voice crack. I'm gonna save the game real quick, but I'm not gonna end the video. I'm just gonna save the game just to be safe. And then what if we switch back? Oh, the Lucis is trying to help. You try, but it's too heavy. It's too small, it's working. I hope the rate is going, it might be old age that... Wait, what? From the powerless test of your crumbly prison pile, you take solace in the mercy that at least there's no claw gunk in here with you. You see the medium book of beasts, the small book of beasts, and several beasts collected in random order in a book. I love this game. This was so worth 5 years of waiting. This desk is in pretty lousy shape on account of the guns piled on top of it. If you need to get it any last minute paperwork done, look elsewhere. What else? Hey, you can see the portal from here, right through this giant hole you made when you inadvertently laser beamed yourself into Damic's home. You hope you're not responsible for any of this damage. Open. Damic seems pretty paranoid. Even if you could crack the safe, it probably wouldn't be safe to do that. So we're supposed to find a hoverboard thingy. Although McGruff the Crime Dog has never explicitly covered this in any of his safety lectures, you probably shouldn't try to climb into a pile of guns. This desk is in pretty lousy shape on the account of guns piled on top of it. If you need to get any last minute paperwork done, look else. Okay, I already read that. Access? No dice, you guess it's out of power, maybe? Oh wait, what? There isn't a handle, this must be opened some other way. No dice. So we have to find another circuit board or something? like anything really. Just what's over there. Okay, no. Steer clear. You aren't going anywhere near damage, clog toilet, or whatever that is. Maybe it's the egg he has shot up. It's gross, but it is. Why is it automatically going to there when I try to click on it? Like, I click on this thingy and it brings me back over there. What even? Okay. What about things we can use up here? What was that thing? Yeah, right here. Just troll idols. What can we use? Whatever this thing is. You don't want to electrocute yourself or bring this stuff to life or whatever. You're not into this. Aha! Do I need to use this on this? Exactly! Aha! Hey, no! You should really get that thing back. Hey! Hey Joey, how's it going? Not great, I accidentally put everything in lockdown. Or maybe it was in lockdown before and I somehow got past one door. That's probably it. The Ted Church has extremely high security. What's the deal? If he's really paranoid, or is your planet really dangerous? It must be, if everyone's house is full of guns. Actually, my hive is pretty different. It's a lot cleaner for one thing, and it has a tree growing in it for my Lucis. And there's no guns. That sounds really nice. What does he even need so many guns for anyway? Well, I guess it's okay to tell you since you're another Rust Blood, but don't tell anyone else, it's a major secret. I don't know a single other person on your entire planet. Okay, alright. Okay, but yeah, so we're rebelling. It's okay, you can take a minute. I know it's a lot to process. Rebelling against what? The man? No, the Harris is a girl. Wait, what's happening? The man? Oh, they must be talking about the Scratch Doctor. I don't know why, I don't like the look of the way this text is formatted. It reminds me of the Scratch Doctor. No, but the Harris is a girl. Oh right, you're an alien, okay. Some context, the Harris is a murdering tyrant who holds our whole planet in her wicked finny fist. Finny? Yes! I knew it! It's the fish lady thing from Homestuck. She's a sea dweller, and Uchisa Blood. Only one of only two. The other one, she's really away all the time, leading the conquest of other galaxies or whatever. Which is lucky for us because she's incredibly powerful. Not so lucky for the people in the other galaxies, though. Huh? Oh yeah, that's true. Anyways, the Harris is enough to deal with. The other Highbloods follow her, and of course she has her drone army. Well, of course, ain't that always just the way? Yeah. I was kidding. I don't know what Highbloods or drone armies or anything are. Hey, to be all, hi, I'm new here and I play. Can you gradually bring me up to speed on literally everything? Watch in amazement as I stun you with my attracting cluelessness, feast on your eyes on my badly executed jokes. Haha, you're pretty upbeat about this. I think if I was suddenly shot across the galaxy or whatever, I'd be flipping out. Aren't you currently bleeding out under a ton of rocks? I guess so. It's kind of annoying to have no idea what's going on. Okay, well, the drones are the things falling around outside. They'll take us into custody if they see us, assuming they don't kill us outright by firing missiles into our... Okay, I'm a derp at reading. Let's start over. They'll take us into custody if they see us, assuming they don't kill us outright by firing missiles into our bodies until we're dead. Oh. Yeah. Okay, well, a lot of this can wait until we get you to safety. I'm gonna find your hover pad now. Talk to you soon. Let's find that hover pad. What's down here? Can I come out? Open. Did you not look at the door before trying that? It's insanely dangerous out there. If you want to make a run for across the street, you better be fast. Oh, that's why I gotta find the hoverboard. That's why I gotta find the hoverboard. Hoverboard, hoverboard. Wherever could you be? Well, big screen TV, you're kinda blown away. This Tetrarch Dammit guy is obviously filled with millionaire money bags. I didn't read that last part. What's that sound? We gotta find some hoverboard thingy. Is it in here? This is getting a little ridiculous. Who locks the door to their kitchen? Is he worried someone is gonna steal his... Okay, there's no way he eats bugs, right? This hole is what you get when you build an elevator into your house while at the same time not caring if people fall down holes. The platform is down in the basement. You can still hear the sound of that wild animal below. Can we throw some of this down there? You'd kind of rather not agitate whatever that weird monster is down there. Also, I might think these are food and choke, and you don't want that either. Or do we? Buyers! If you let him go down there, you're not confident he'd be able to find his way back. And yeah, he just have to follow the light papyrus and this for his most mods. Hold on, I need to do this again. This is hilarious. Buyers is not a snack. Okay, we need to find the hoverboard. What's this? If I go back here, it just takes me here. There's nothing I can really click on. Whatever that is, that's weird. Jeez, Dammit really doesn't like this fish lady, huh? You don't know what the whole deal is, but she seems pretty stylish, at least from what we can make out of the lunatic scribblings. That's what we all thought when we read Homestuck. That's what we all thought. What's this? You assume this is a trophy for best hero cat menace fawn drash bronco in show. I really don't know where to look. Let's try our flashlight somewhere. If you run down the battery, you have no idea where you get more. Better save it for when you really need it. Dammit has gone back and forth between the Grubbles and the Grubbles several times. The Grub L's. The Grubble seems to be the current favorite, though at least it crosses out and writes something beneath it. Okay, so Joey can understand this language for some strange reason. A computer. You wonder if Dammit ever makes his own video games as a means of hashing out his problems like Clarissa does. Clarissa is so cool. Nope, not your problem. Okay, what? Oh, gross, someone left food and a big bug into it, or he eats bugs. Probably, that's all anyone here ever eats. You really, really wish you'd eaten something before you got here. Or wait, wish you had or hadn't. You had, okay. But where do I find that hoverboard? I'll be right back, folks. Oh, hey! What's this? Another JavaScript snake thing? And this time there's an enemy? Look, Exorox, are you there? Can't really go anywhere else, but the debris slowly is crushing my body. Oh, right, sorry. It's okay. I'll be there soon. Try to hang in there. Okay, I'll try. I'm gonna pass out a little now. Alright, wait, really quick. I'm having trouble with the security puzzle, you could call it. I sold the one in the basement also, but this one seems kinda different. Security puzzle? Deeming the serpent from the Tetrarch Dammit rigged up his power hexagrid. I wouldn't have used those words, but if you think that's what I'm talking about, it probably is. There's another one? A different one? I think so. The star screen is different anyway. And the power still also, I don't know what it'd be connected to. His hive security, probably. He's always tinkering with it to make it more complex. Yeah, for the one in the basement, I only had to eat the letters, but now they're different. There's a different letter to eat, but I don't know what letters to eat, if that makes sense. Oh, it's probably XXXX. Oh, really? No, wait, sorry, I mean XXXXX. Yeah, I got it. No, that's not it. What? I'm typing in it, but I keep getting it changed to a bunch of X's. Maybe it's the new security software I installed. It must stop me from posting my password to the chat. Really? Let me try. Mr. Stay Lord Thomas 80. That's Andrew's Hussey's password, everyone. Start doing your hat. Nah, I'm just kidding. Yeah, OMG. What's that? No. You told me it would turn into X symbols. Well, you were using Tetrarch's hip, but it wouldn't know your password. I can't believe I did that. I'm going home. I can never show my face on this planet again. What? It seems like a nice password. I never guessed that. You must be really smart, Joey. No, apparently I'm super stupid. What's so embarrassing about it? Everybody makes mistakes. It's just... Actually, I guess it's the name of a boy, like... Really? Don't tell anyone, but that's what my password is, too. Oh? You have a girl you like? No, oh no, it's a boy. For some reason, I thought you were a boy all this time. I am. Oh. Huh. So I'm not to rush you or anything, but I'm still dying in rocks. Okay, so this guy's gay. About the security console? Yeah. About that. Can you, like, give me a hint? It's the name of your brand, but there's a couple different ways to spell it. That's pretty weird. Yeah, we keep going back and forth between that blah, censored password and censored password. I actually don't know which one right now. It is right now. I'll scout around and see if I can find something. He's bound to have written it down somewhere or something, right? I hope so. I'm gonna converse my strength a little bit, maybe, getting kinda dead. Hang in there, I'll be there as soon as I can. Let's try this again, hang on. Aha! It's written right here in the top, right corner. So we have to get the one over here first. And then we have to get a U. At least that's what it looks like to me. What else does it say? What does it say next? Oh, I have to get this weird F. What do we have to get next? The B. B. And another B. Okay, so it's not here. And then what next? This, weird thing. Wait, what happened? Did I get it wrong? I got it wrong, didn't I? Okay, let's try that again. Okay, so the U. And then... right here. And then we have to get... B, and then the B, let's get it, please, the B and the B, and then whatever this thing is, oh, did we get it wrong, oh, I got it right. Apparently I got it right that time. Let's try this again. crap. Yeah! We did it. Oh. Oh no. Poor Joey. Oh no. Oh no. See, right there, did you just see that thing fly by? That looks like the symbol of the hairness. I figured out the game, but the monster chased me into I'm fairly confident to this is a kitchen. It's really gross, but anyway, keeping you informed, monster. Hey, sorry, I'm a little woozy. It's your cat. Oh yeah, now I remember. The Ted Charles loses. Okay, sure. Oh yeah, a second, maybe you can fill me on what that means. What means? What's a loosis? Wow. What? That's just about the saddest thing I ever heard get said. Yeah, culture differences, etc., etc. Can you bring me out to speed on wild beasts that stalking me? Why does Damick even have a crazy cat monster in his house? Are you usually crazy? Your loosis takes care of you, protects you from wild monsters, and also dying from, like, whatever, you know? I guess mine's not too good at this instead of being crushed by heavy debris. Not really? Are they all, beasts? Yeah, what else would they be? And they're always this rambunctious? I mean, it seems like if I'd be pretty crazy if everyone in your family had their own rip-snorting monster. What's a family? It's some adults and their kids, or one adult and one, some kids, or some kids and their babysitter and the conspicuous absence of a father who isn't garbage. Adults? Yeah, why? Adults live on your planet? Of course. Is that not where they live for you? For you adults? For your adults, sorry, this is the weirdest thing you said yet. Sorry, this is somehow the weirdest thing you said yet. Once you come of your age, you get sent off planet from your ordeals. And that's it, nobody ever comes back. No exceptions, there are no adults, only on Alternia. That's the name of the planet, Alternia. I think it might be another wow, I'm in an alien conversation, but it's safe when you're not pinned under a bunch of rocks. I'm gonna have to rest in a sec. Okay, well, I'm gonna find the hover pad. I'll let you know what I do. Thanks, Joey. I'm gonna focus on maintaining consciousness, I think. Good plan. Stay alive. Kid power. Oh, jeez, that was awful. Sorry, bye. It's really gross. Maybe you can clean it? You definitely traveled to a strange alien world to deep clean this guy's kitchen. That's how you live your life, for sure. Is this the hover pad? This is Cruel Aid? Oh, you get it. This place is kind of horrible. What about right here? Okay, I'm not even gonna bother looking through all that. Ascend! And let's find that hoverboard. Is this it? X-Frost says this is his, but it looks like Damick, he has other ideas. Oh, well, Damick isn't here. Now you can help X-Frost with it and help X-Frost by returning it. I found the hover pad! Hover sled? Whatever it's called. I got it. I can come save you. Excellent! Although I think I'm a little boxed in. Between the deer cat and this pile of guns and drums, I don't think I have a clear path. Oh, well, I'll figure it out. Well, the Tetrarch made some pretty excessive modifications to my hover pad. That might be able to help. Yeah, this guy doesn't sound good, like he has a good sense of respect for boundaries or personal property. Oh, he hates it. Tetrarch Damick says the concept of private property is a vehicle for exploitation and the tool by which high bloods subjugate the low blood underclass. Well, I'm new here. I can't really comment, I guess. Anyways, I'll be back in your hands now, so problem solved. Okay, I'll give it a shot. Talk to you soon. Do we go back? I'm gonna go back. Find the hoverboard and use it like that. The door can open on its own just fine. It's just there's an angry deer cat on the other side. Astonishingly, a problem not solved by hovering. Probably the first you've ever encountered. But didn't it say it had the extra modifications? Didn't it? So we can bust through there, right? Oh my god. Okay, wait. Hoverboard? Blah. Oh. Oh! Oh, a giant hole. Eh? Eh. Eh? If the Tetrarchosaurus is upset, it might have got X hurt. Got X? Oh, got 10. That's cute. Anyways, I did see a whole lot of blood smeared up to a huge hole in the floor. Oh no. It was brown, so it's pretty old. I'm not sure what you mean. The Tetrarch is a bronze blood. So that's either Damic or is Lucis, and it's recent. Wait. Okay, you've been saying things about blood color a lot, but I've been assuming it was metaphorical. Are you saying members of your species literally have different colors of blood? Yeah, I'm a rust blood. Bronze rust, so it's a metals thing? No, it's by color. I'm actually, Burgundy blood, but maybe this isn't the best time to talk about all this. Yo, I'll be glad to tell you all about the blood on your planet when I'm not leaking so much of it on the ground. Well, I really thought it'd be dead by now. Don't worry, I'm coming as soon as I figure out a way past this beast. Maybe I can outrun him. I'm surprised he's been chasing you. That's not really like him. Well, now that you mention it, he did exactly chase me. He didn't exactly chase me. Maybe I can give him a treat. I do have some pet treats. What's a pet? I think it'd be a little weird if I described it to you, given the fact that it sounds like raised by one. Let's move on. Maybe I can sneak past him. Pretty unlikely! Wait, are you the kind of alien that's invisible and silent? No. Yeah, no chance then. I think this might all be a misunderstanding. He's probably upset. With Damic missing and everything that happened before you got here, they can be kind of frustrating. Lucises, I mean. They mean well, and they try to take care of you, but they don't always know what they're doing. And it's always easy to understand them, you know? Yeah, I have some like that. Oh? Yeah, my babysitter. You'd love her. Her name has an X in it. Eh? Well, okay, if we got a beast on our hands, there's really only one thing to do. Yeah? Joey Claire, amateur veterinarian, is going pro. BRB. Oh, we're going to take care of it. We're going to take care of it. Oh, this is what Joey wanted to be, a veterinarian, which is like, veterinarian, the doctor for pets. We're going to be taking, back out here. Oh! I love this game. That face. That rampaging deer cat out there is still pretty furious. You've got to find some way to distract it so you can approach it from the other side. The hover pad dumped a hodgepodge of guns, drums, and rubble into that hole, where it seems to have disintegrated onto the force field. So what do we do? Fly the hoverboard down here? Hang on. Click. Click. Does nothing. Just a typical air vent, previously repurposed as a human vent, but it mostly deals in air. Can we fly through here? It won't fit, and you don't have any plans to go back through that dangerous vent shaft, even if you are lowered gently by the careful embrace of the hover pad. Doesn't really seem to be its style anyway. Do I have to click on the... What do I click on? I've been playing for a while now, I might end the video soon, but I can tell I'm close to the end. Wait, what's this? What am I equipping? No. Oh, the guns! Hold on, I'm gonna look at this cutscene again. Okay, let's read this. Approach from the other side? I'm not sure what to do. Use. It opened. The door opened. You can now proceed ingeniously. No, that's not what I meant to do. Oh my god. Now what do we do? Just click on this and then... click on this and this. Click on this. Wait, click on this and this. No? What do we do? Do we combine the hoverboard and the... By hovering, it would be immune to your taps. It has a dream time logic to that, doesn't it? You don't need a hover pad to defy gravity. So what do we do? A way to distract it? Let's see if we can open the safe again. The hover pad might be able to lift the safe, it might not, but you don't have time to mess around there. Exifrost needs your help. How do we do that though? Wait, what? Something is said something about something. What's this? This desk isn't pretty. Why is it taking me? I'm trying to click over there. Oh, wait, because it's. Wait, what? I can ascend? Oh, I can. Can I go around? Can I go around? Now, let's see if we can head back out here. Oh, wait, what is it? You don't want to tangle with the terrifying deer cat while he's still so terrifying. Maybe if he could be calmed down somehow, or at the very least distracted. How am I gonna do that? How am I gonna do that? It's really gross. Hang on. This cabinet is empty. Wait. There's a bowl in the back, a clean bowl. Maybe Damoc missed it too, that would explain why it's actually clean. Oh, do we gotta fill it up with something? Like, let's look in this fridge of fridges. Let me see if I can take anything. Aha! 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 Ascend! Now, let's do this. Down here, descend. Now, let's head out. Oh, is it gonna put me through this again? Show him the milk, man. Yep, it just put me through that again. I don't know what to do. What? Oh my god, stop it. Stop it. Oh, I need to approach it from behind. Let's ascend again. And let's see where we are. So I'm gonna... How did I get up there the other time? Now let's go over here. Exit. Exit. Out here. Oh, you're kidding. Like, what about if we combine these? Virus is lactose intolerant, you're pretty sure. Those stuff may not actually contain lactose. You know what, you're not gonna overthink it. So that'll calm the beast, right? So is there anything else we need? No, it doesn't look like that. Now how do we distract it? Now the only items we can find useful here. So there's still nothing in this cabinet. Stairs. Now let's see what we can do. Well, we're limited to only those areas. Well, let's see what we can click on. What's all this? Looks like Damek's pretty into guns. You resolve to be a little more cautious when solving his goofy paranoia puzzles. Also, if you ever, like, met him in person. Which, let's not. Hopefully that won't happen. Why do all these have the same dorky symbol on them? What's this? Just think of all the possibilities for alien animal care held in this little kit. Aha! You kind of regretted not taking this one from your bedroom, but this more than makes up for that absurd blunder. Can you use the bowl of loose smoke to distract the ear cut? While you may be like, you're not sure. Do something with the vet med kit? There's a lot of variables you consider, you just haven't ironed all the kinks yet. Let's descend and see if that works. Let's open the door. Hopefully we don't have to go through that dumb cutscene. We have to go through the dumb cutscene, don't we? We have to go through the dumb cutscene. Let's go out through the other way then. See what we can do. Ascend. And let's keep going through that way. Exit. And let's see if we can go out this way. Please. What else is there to do? I'm getting really annoyed. I think I'm actually gonna end the video now. Hang on though. Just hang on one bit. Maybe we can do some last minute looking around. What's up here then? Looks like Damek has speakers all over his house. You know, for a guy who's apparently obsessed with conspiracy and secrecy, he sure seems to be kind of a showy jackass. Whatever. There's nothing else to do. There's nothing else to do. You're kidding me. What else? I don't know, this bull's already holding the milk pretty expertly. Transporting loose milk by way of hover beam sounds like playing with fire. The hover pad slash hover pad slash hover sled does have a nice antlers, but you're pretty sure it's not actually a live animal. Equip guns? No. Whatever, I'm gonna end the video now. So I hope you guys enjoyed today's episode of Hype Swap. I don't know how long I've recorded, it felt like ages to me. If you did, leave a like if you want to see more. Subscribe for more content like this. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.